This video tutorial will discuss storing credit cards securely in your ShopSite store. Making sure that you're storing credit cards securely is part of being PCI compliant. First, let's look at how we're choosing to process our orders. Go to Commerce Setup, then click on Payment, and scroll down to the list of credit card processors. ShopSite has a built-in integration with many real-time payment gateways for credit card processing. With these gateways, when an order is placed, the credit card information is processed automatically through the payment gateway. Because this is an automatic process, you don't need to store the credit card information in your ShopSite store. However, for merchants who are choosing manual offline credit card processing, you will need to store the credit card information in your ShopSite store so that you can process the credit cards later outside of ShopSite. For manual credit card processing, you'll want to make sure that you're storing those credit cards securely in your ShopSite store. So for this, let's scroll to the top, click on Orders, and view some of our orders. You'll see right now my card security is only at medium. This means that although my ShopSite store is using an SSL, so it is secure, and the credit card information is being encrypted on the server, the credit cards aren't entirely secure. The reason is that anyone who has access to my ShopSite store can view the orders and grab the credit card information directly on that screen. So they would need to have access to my ShopSite store, but they can still get all of the order information if they have access to my ShopSite store. I'm going to change this so that only I can view the credit card information, even if other people have access to my store. For this, scroll to the bottom, click on Security, then click on Credit Card Storage. You'll see three options listed here. Symmetric encryption is what I currently have, so the credit cards are encrypted on the server, but not encrypted in the back office. Do not store credit cards is for if you're using a payment gateway, you do not need to store the credit card information in your store. What I want to set up is asymmetric encryption. This is part of being PCI compliant. So click on Configure Merchant Key, and then click on Create New Key. This will take you through the key generation wizard. Click Next to go to the second step, where you actually will generate the key. This key is really important. You're going to want to save it on your computer somewhere where you know where it's at, as well as make a backup of it on a CD or some other way of making a backup of this merchant key. If you lose the merchant key, you will not be able to view any credit card information. I'm going to save this key directly on my desktop, just for the purpose of this tutorial. Again, you'll want to save it somewhere where it's more secure, but somewhere where you know where it's at, as well as making that backup. Once you've downloaded it, you can close this window and then continue through the generation key setup. On this step, we're going to upload the merchant key to test it. So upload, find the key, open it, then click on Next. You now have 30 minutes to view credit card information in your store. So click on Next. Make sure you have the key encryption turned on. And then you can return to your order screen. Now let's place a test order. To save on time, I've already placed another new test order. So you'll see I have the new order listed here. Currently, my credit cards are unlocked. Let's just see what this looks like when the credit cards are locked. So I'm going to lock the credit card information, then view the order I just got. You'll see that when I look at where the credit card information is at, everything is currently locked. Scroll to the bottom, click on OK. Now when you're ready to process the order, you can upload your merchant key from your computer. So click on where it says locked. You can browse your computer, upload your merchant key, and then it'll return you to the order screen, and again, the credit cards are now unlocked. And you'll see that our card security is now high. If I click on that same order and view the order, first you get a warning. This is only for the CVV2 code, which is the code that's typically on the back of credit cards. This code will only be shown this one time. So the first time you view the order with the credit card information, you'll want to make sure that you process it immediately because you won't be able to see the CVV code again. Click on OK, And now you can process the order, because here you have the credit card information. If I scroll to the bottom and click on OK, and if I try to view the order again, my credit cards are still unlocked, so I should still be able to see the credit card information. But you'll see now that CVV code is purged, and you won't be able to get it back, but you do still have the credit card information. Click on OK at the bottom, and when you're done viewing your orders, you'll want to lock the credit cards again. Click on Yes to lock it, and now you can't view the credit cards. If I go into an order again, you'll see that again, that information has become locked. This completes the video tutorial on storing credit cards in your ShopSite store.